What's up, everyone? It's Lee here, the rental guy. It's Saturday. Welcome to the vlog. For those of you who don't know, I have a party rental business. I'm in my office right now. This is my party rental business. I've grown it from the garage of my house over the past four-ish years. Yada, yada, you get it. Let's get into the vlog about the party rental business, what we do here, what's going on this week. So, in the past week, I did 13.1K, a lot of smaller orders out this week. As for tents, I had a 20 by 60 that went out, and I had a 20 by 20, and then some smalls. As you can see right here, when we drop off our chairs, we actually have an all-terrain cart that we leave the chairs on just in case you need to move them. And then it's very handy with the ratchet on top. And then when we come and pick up the tables and chairs from you, you can just have them stacked back up on the cart like so, so that we can very fast just wheel them onto our cart and be gone. So it's fast in and fast out using these all-terrain carts. So if you are ordering chairs with your order, you can expect an all-terrain cart to be delivered with it. Next week is even more slow. So far we're brushing just under 10K, but this doesn't stop me from staffing up, because a slow week means a week where you can play catch up, because the week after that is absolutely bananas, and then it goes bananas all through July after that. So I have to stay prepared. So I'm getting all the staff in, I'm stacking them, I'm making them clean, we're fixing things, we're cleaning these tents so that they can get dirty again. I'm going to tell you one of the secrets to set up a 10 by 20 pop-up tent. You may think it's pretty straightforward to set up a 10 by 20 pop-up tent, but that's not always the case. So through our experience, I'll tell you what we've learned. And the one most important thing is keeping all the legs off the ground while you open it, so that nothing gets the chance to bend, because a pop-up tent is at its weakest state before it's fully erected, right? And that's when all the damage typically happens, because once it's all put together, the frame is pretty strong because every piece is right where it's supposed to be. So the real secret for us is this middle part right here on the 10-foot side. So when you've extended it about this far, all you have to do is just grab this middle piece here, and then someone else, your partner, the second person setting up the tent with you, they grab the other side, and then you lift up, make sure all the legs are off the ground, and then you just give it a light shake until it comes almost fully extended. And then from there, all you have to do is just pull up each of the arms to its spot so that it buckles into the hole there. So while we're popping up tents to test them, we open them up about this far, and then we go around just making sure if any are broken, we replace the arms, but then we also tighten the anything that's loose, because every time it comes back, things loosen up a little bit. When you have your tent popped down to about this far, before you close it up, you just want to give the top just a little fluff so that none of the top pieces get stuck inside the arms that scissor close, so that you don't get bunched up pieces that get wrecked in between the arms of the tent. Oh, on kind of the cheaper tents, you will get slices in the tent, but you don't want to be replacing tent tops, you know, until the end of the season. So what you do is take this stuff right here, Gorilla tape, and we just put a piece of tape on one side and then put a piece of tape on the other side. Finally changed the front of the showroom because we needed more space to press linen, so it's currently like this now. Those tables are working excellent.
12 feet.
Oh no, I stole some out of there.
Oh, yeah.
I put 25s in each one of these.
Okay. So this is just leftover.
Well, then no. You need to count the most of that. Oh. 175.
Gotcha.
Right?
Yeah.
So you all know I kind of do games almost as a hobby, right? Yeah, he took the snow cones. Does it work?
We're killing cows over here.
Cows? Where's the bucks?
You shot another cow though. That doesn't matter. I'm off the mic. I'm winning.
Did you build the riser?
No, we haven't yet.
Okay, well, we don't have enough time today.
Yeah.
That's it. Levi, you stay here and warm up the machine for us.
Warm up.
So I've had the Pac-Man machine forever, but this week I picked up NBA Jam, Street Fighter 2, and then the Big Buck Hunter. I needed the Big Buck Hunter because I had it on my website and it's taking bookings, so I needed to get one. But I found a deal. Big Buck Hunter, NBA Jam, and Street Fighter all came together. So now I've thrown some packages on my website for, arcade packages. The arcades seem to go out, you know, 3-4 times a year, and they do pay for themselves, but they're just like a fun thing to own, right? Hey Jace, here's a sheet for the snow cone machine. So this week has been the week of sheets and the week of dirty. And what I mean is that everything that doesn't get a sheet packed with it comes back absolutely dirty. And sometimes even things that get sheets packed with them are absolutely dirty. And we have really become, you know, a lot of catering items and, you know, a lot of dishes, like right here in the back. What's he doing? Dishes. There's a lot of dishes going on. A carrot? I said there's no food on the plates. They're in big trouble now. Dish catering cleaning sheet. Oh, thank you for choosing us for your dishes. Oh, there's a charge that starts at $1 per item. Minimum charge of $50. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Oh. Like, for instance, this barbecue right here, it came back absolutely dirty, you know, patties in it. We packed a barbecue sheet that said, you will be charged the cleaning fee dirty barbecue charge email template. Those snaky buggers with the barbecues, they don't even care, the barbecue people. And they didn't care, they returned it dirty. So I slammed them with charges and they didn't say anything. I charged them $75 to clean the barbecue. And back for order blah 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 for renting the barbecue. We appreciate your business and hope that you enjoyed your event. Unfortunately, we received the barbecue back in an unclean state. We understand that accidents happened and we're happy to take care of the cleaning for you. However, we will have to charge a $50 cleaning fee for this service. As mentioned in our return reminder email that the rentals need to be wiped before return to avoid any additional cleaning charges. Rentals that are visibly dirty or dusty and show no signs of wiping and are subject to a cleaning fee that starts at $25. In addition to time needed to do any deep cleaning on items that are very dirty, the payment will be taken off your credit card that you initially paid with. Please let us know if you have any questions or concerns. Don't be afraid to charge people for these things. They're abusing your rentals. Like, for instance, we've got the cotton candy machine right here. It's gonna be going out right inside. There's a cleaning sheet right in there that says they get charged if it's not clean coming back. That one has been cleaned every single time. You know, blah, blah, blah. We hope you enjoy the cotton candy machine. Turn the power on, let it heat for 10 minutes, blah, blah, blah. How to clean the machine. Machine needs to be clean. Disclaimer, blah, blah, blah. Will charge deducted user's credit card. The popcorn machine, the cotton candy, and the snow cone machine, every time everyone cleans it because, you know, the sheets that we send with them are so threatening. So when people don't return things on time, which happened a few times this week, I get really, really, really mad and I charge them right away, and that puts their butts into gear. So what I do is I always send reminders for people to come pick up, and if they're late, we start calling them, where are you? But then we send them reminders to return, and then when they didn't return on time, we send them a text message, an email, and a phone call before the end of the business day. And if they don't get back to us, then we automatically charge their card on file for 25% of the rental price. And we say, actually, I'll show you the email, what we say to them. And we're serious about this. Unless they, you know, call us and let us know that they're gonna be late, then we can be nice if it's not due to be rented out the next day. Okay, so here's our rentals late email that we sent. Hope you enjoyed our event rentals, but you're late. Please call us right away to return the rentals. And then if they don't return our phone calls or our text messages or anything by the end of the day, this is what we send them. We get it one step meaner. By this point, they've already made us mad. They don't really care about returning and they have to be taught a lesson. So if you have it in your contract that you say that you're taking this money off if they don't return on time, well then you have the right to take it off if they don't return on time, especially if they're not giving you communication. You be rude on this and you're gonna get your stuff back right away. This is what the template says. Greetings. We hope you are doing well and that you had a wonderful time with our event rentals. We are writing to follow up with you regarding your rental return. Your rentals were due back by blah, 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 but we have not received them yet. We have sent you several emails and phone calls, but we have not given you any response from you. We are sure that you're busy and that you may have forgotten to return your rentals, but we kindly request that you contact us as soon as possible to arrange a new drop-off time. Our rentals are in high demand and we need them back to serve other customers who are waiting for them. As per our rental agreement, we have charged your credit card on file a 25% late fee for each day that your rentals are overdue. This fee will continue until you return your rentals or until they are considered lost or damaged. Please call us right away to let us know when you can return the rentals. If we do not hear from you within the next 48 hours, we will have no choice but to report your rentals missing and take further action. Our return address is blah, 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 blah. We value your business and we hope to hear from you soon. You send that to them and they will only be charged for one day because they are going to start getting back to you right away. They're going to look on their credit card. They're going to see that it's charged for 25%, but they're not going to complain that they get charged because it's all in the contract and they knew this going in. As long as you pre-prepare them for it, you know, if you're late, you're screwed. Sorry, but you know, we've got a business to run here. So make it very clear, charge their cards, teach them a lesson, but be very verbal with them. Make sure and call them, email them, text message them, all of it. We do all of that so that they can't miss the late reminders. Sometimes customers slip through a loophole, something that we didn't think of yet. They bring it back dirty or damaged. And then what we do is we make a sheet. So just get as many sheets as you can. It's like, oh, you know, the arcade cabinet. Blah, 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 needs a sheet. The dishes, they must come back. You know, the linens, they must be packed a certain way. The dishes must come back a certain way. The barbecue must come back a certain way. The chairs must be stacked upon pickup for this. If you don't have these rules set forward, you will not create an expectation for the customers and they won't know to do this. It's going to make you angry and it's not going to be labor saving for you. And at the end of the day, the system doesn't work as well. So if you implement these processes, you can fix problems before they arise by warning people and educating them. And the people who don't care, well, you make money off them because they get charged for not following your rules. This is your rental company. You make the rules. So enforce the rules. Make sure and click into this playlist right here because that will show you all the vlogs that I've been doing. It'll just keep showing them to you. So if you want to just see all the vlogs, click right there to hit the playlist. That is my ask. As always, you stay classy. We'll see you on the next one.